Hi guys, this is Rice Snow. It's been a while. Sorry for not being so active lately. And this video is about kind of why. So today I released my game on Steam. The game is called Zenvader. It is a super retro style shooting game. So, as you can see, it is heavily inspired by classic shooters such as Space Invaders, but it is also a roguelite with a lot of power-ups and bullets. So, you can earn some points by defeating aliens, and you can spend them to unlock new weapons or increase your parameters. So, there are four units that you can use, and each has different abilities. The main campaign mode has 25 stages, and if you defeat the final boss, you can beat the game. Pretty simple, but also pretty challenging, I think. So this is the first game I ever released on Steam. If you are interested, please check it out. So I started developing this game about a year and a half ago, after making my chess tutorial video. I was wondering what I would program next. At first, I thought, okay, I had never developed a shooting game in Java, so let's see if I could write a program for it. So I called it Player Movement and Shooting Mechanics. So I could move and shoot enemies, and it worked. Then I thought, okay, but just shooting enemies is kind of boring, so it would be more fun if I could get some power-ups and improve my unit. So I implemented that, and then I also wanted to make it like an RPG because I like RPGs. So I edited the code so you could get sort of experience points by defeating aliens, and you could improve your parameters and get new weapons by spending the points. That's also a pretty basic mechanic for roguelite games. Initially, it was just another one of my coding experiments. Maybe I could make another tutorial video based on it, type of thing. But eventually, I got obsessed with the development itself. And after a while, I let a few of my friends play the game, saying, "Hey, I'm making this super retro game, so please check it out." Then some of them seemed to like it and suggested that I should release this to the public because other people might enjoy it too. So I decided to polish it more and officially release it. And at this point, I decided to use libgdx, which is a Java game framework, because I wanted to implement game controller support, and libgdx had a nice class for it. At first, I was thinking to release it on my itch page, but then I thought, I had never released a game on Steam, and I was always curious to know how it works. So yeah, I thought it would be an interesting experience and decided to do that. So I did a little research about how to uploading a game to Steam and learned that you need to register to a service called Steamworks, which is a website, but kind of works as a framework for developers. So I registered my personal information, submitted my ID, etc. And also, you have to pay. I think it was $100 for uploading a single game. So if you upload two games, you pay 200. Also, I realized Steamworks is a very well-made system. Easy to understand, easy to use. Everything is very well explained. So you can upload your build and you can manage every version and every update, without deleting everything. So you can update only what you have changed and it is done automatically. So you can upload your game with a zip file. So if you are developing your game in Java, you just need to convert your jar file to an exe file and create a zip file by packaging it with your JDK. Or if your file size is larger than 2 GB, you can use the Steamworks SDK to do that. But I haven't tried this SDK yet because my game is only like 400 megabyte. So I just prepared a zip file and uploaded it. Then I created a store page. Then I submitted the game build to Valve for review. And actually, they gave me kind of a detailed reviews. I was surprised, to be honest, because I know so many people are trying to upload their games on Steam, so I was kind of suspecting that maybe they wouldn't check my game so seriously, but they pointed out some pretty specific stuff, like we found that if you disconnect your controller during the gameplay, then the game doesn't detect controllers anymore until you restart the game, and maybe you want to fix it. Something like that. And that I fixed it. But what they said ultimately was, so we have found some stuff that you might want to fix, but overall, we didn't find any critical issues, so you can release the game. So that's how it happened. And it was a pretty interesting experience, so I wanted to share it with you guys. As I said, if you are interested, please check the game on Steam, and I'd love to hear what you think. I will keep my eyes on feedback and maybe update the game in the future based on it. Yep, so that's it for today. If you have any questions, feel free to leave comments. Thanks for watching, and until next time.